Please subscribe the channel and don't forget to click the bell icon.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Welcome to Botanica. So we have discussed about the different types of plant movements which are present in the plants. So we were discussing about growth movements. So as far as the tropism is concerned, we have discussed about the phototropism, geotropism, and we have also many other types of tropisms. So generally we call it a tropism, a mechanism. So this is a tropism, either it is phototropism, geotropism, hydrotropism. So these are named after the inducing agent. So that particular tropism, that particular movement of the plant, it is named according to the inducible agent. For example, if that tropism is caused by the light, so it will be called as phototropism, as light is the inducing agent. Light is the agent which is causing that particular tropism, so it will be called as phototropism. So this is the naming convention of this particular tropism. Gravitropism, induced by gravity. Hydrotropism, induced by water. Thigmotropism, induced by contact. And tromotropism, induced by injury. So these are all the types of tropisms, movement of the plants according to the towards the stimulus. So phototropism, for example, if we talk about the phototropism, plants are generally, shoot system is positively phototropic, while the root system is negatively phototropic. While in gravitropism, it is opposite. Root is positively gravitropic and shoot system is negatively gravitropic, so as it is induced by the gravity. So hydrotropism, so it is also according to the water availability. Roots mostly grow towards the source of water, so they will be positively hydrotropic. So in most of the time, so we need to talk about the habitat of the plant. Either the plant is growing in the pond or the water, or it is growing in the desert environment. So are in thigmotropism, induced by the contact. So there are many plants which are growing on another plant, saprobes or any other plants. So unke jo stems hain, they are growing in the plant. So unme thigmotropism, contact ka ek tropism bhi hota hai ki kis taraf unhone grow karna hai. And at last we have tromotropism, which is induced by the injury. So these are all types of tropism and we are going to discuss it. So first of all, we are going to talk about the phototropism. So as the name of phototropism indicates, it is the movement of curvature. So it is not the complete movement of the plant, it is the movement of curvature, differential growth. So this particular tropism or the phototropism can be attributed, can be defined in a manner that it is a differential difference in growth. It is shown by the curvature of the plant, is shown by the plant organ in response to light. So aerial cylindrical plant organs grow towards light, as we have discussed about that. Shoot system is positively phototropic while the root system is negatively phototropic. So aerial plants which are growing above the soil surface, so these are aerial cylindrical plants. Either they are root, either they are stems, either they are branches, either they are leaves. So these are all aerial parts. So we are talking about aerial cylindrical plant organs. So what are those? So either it is stem of the plant, or there will be hypocotyle. So what is hypocotyle? So when the seed germinates, so that is the stem, the germinating seed, or we can say that the stem of the germinating seed is called as germinating seedling is called as hypocotyle, is the stem of a germinating seedling. So either it is a stem, so complete stem, mature stem, so we will call it a stem. But when the seed is germinating and it is at the seedling state, so that particular stem will be called as hypocotyle, or it will be coleoptile. What is a coleoptile? Mostly this particular coleoptile is present in the family of grasses, a sheath protecting a young shoot tip in a grass or cereal. So this is found in the family Poaceae, and this is simply a sheath which protects the young shoot tip, so it is called as coleoptile. So these are all aerial cylindrical plant organs, so which grow towards light. Either it is stem, mature stem, either it is hypocotyle, or it is coleoptile. So they are positively phototropic. But roots, on the contrary, on the opposite side, in contrast to stems and aerial cylindrical parts of the plant, the roots on the contrary tend to grow away from the light and are known as negatively phototropic. So as these two tropisms, geotropism and phototropism, they are opposite to one another, So as far as the roots are concerned, they are negatively phototropic, and this response is called negative phototropism. But in positive phototropism, so here is the concept of differential growth. So as far as the positive phototropism is concerned, illuminated side, the side where the light is present, light source is present. So that particular light source is usually the sun. But when we are doing experiment in lab or in in vitro experiments are carried out there, the light source can be something else, and it may not be a sun. So if we are carrying out that particular experiment in a lab, so there the light source may be illuminated light bulbs or anything else. So that particular illuminated side to which the light source is present, it will show slower growth than the darker side. So what happens when we compare the growth, when we compare or when we talk about the mechanism of phototropism? So what happens here, the illuminated side, the source where the light is present, that this particular side, the growth at this particular side is slow. So how we can say that the growth is slow? We are comparing it with the other side, which is darker side. So that particular darker side grow at a rapid rate, at a higher rate. So that's why we can say that the growth at the illuminated side is slow, and at the darker side it is more rapid, comparatively higher. As a result of this particular differential growth क्या मतलब, illuminated side और darker side पे जो difference है growth की speed का, so this particular plant organ will bend towards the source of light, क्योंकि एक side जो है वो growth जो है उसमें कम होती है और दूसरी side में growth ज़्यादा होती है, तो वो जो हमारे पास plant organ है it will bend towards the source of light, and how it occurs we are going to see it in the next slide. So phototropic response is known to be initiated in the tip and transferred to the growing region. So as far as the mechanism is concerned, so it was not known that what is the causing agent, ke kis tarike se phototropic response jo hai wo usko initiate kiya jata hai, kya cheez uske liye responsible hai. But as far as the early experiment are concerned, it was known that the response of phototropism, it is initiated at the tip. Tip of the plant, the growing region, meristematic region of the plant, and that particular response, that particular chemical, that particular signaling agent will be transferred to the growing region or the lower part of the plant. So इससे पहले ये चीज मालूम थी कि कौन सा जो है chemical जो है वो responsible है इसकी growth के लिए, लेकिन ये चीज पहले से ही मालूम थी. This concept was clear कि something is present at the tip which is transported to the lower parts of the plant. So this is said to be the growing region. Growing region का क्या मतलब, ये tip का जो region है, this is the growing region. So the response is initiated at the growing region, at the tip of the plant, and then that particular response is transferred to the other parts of the plant, and due to which the phototropic response occurs. So as far as the mechanism is concerned, there were many experiments which were carried out to know where the response is started and what happens in the phototropic response. So simply most of the time what happens that all these experiments are attributed to F.W. Wendt, who carried out the last experiment in the 1928, but these experiments on the oat-coleoptera carried out by different scientists, as they are carried, first of all they are carried out by Darwin, Charles Darwin, in 1880s. So what happens, so what the experiment he carried out, he grown the this particular oat coleoptile towards the, so isne jab in coleoptiles ko grow kiya, germinate kiya towards, this is the source of light, this is the sun. So normal condition mein kya hua ki this oat coleoptile bends towards the source of light. To abhi jo hum baat kar rahe the differential growth ki, to yahi thi ki this is the illuminated side, if this is agar ye isko hum pehle ye kare ki ye bilkul स्ट्रेट है, तो स्ट्रेट में क्या होगा कि दिस साइड विल बी इल्यूमिनेटेड एंड दिस पर्टिकुलर साइड विल बी एट डार्कर साइड बिकॉज द सन इज प्रेजेंट एट राइट साइड. तो ये साइड जो है हमारे पास ये इल्यूमिनेटेड हो जाएगी, लाइट सोर्स की जो साइड है वो हो जाएगी, और ये हमारे पास डार्कर साइड. तो इन दोनों में जो ग्रोथ है वो डिफरेंस होती है, देयर इज अ डिफरेंशियल ग्रोथ. सो व्हाट हैपेंस, द ग्रोथ रेट एट दिस पर्टिकुलर इल्यूमिनेटेड साइड इज लोअर एज स्लोअर एज कंपेयर टू दिस पर्टिकुलर डार्कर साइड. So due to this particular mechanism, this particular phenomena, this particular coleoptile will bend towards the source of light as growth is more rapid at this site, darker site, and slower at this particular site. So what in Darwin experiment, normal condition coleoptile bends towards the source of light, but top of the coleoptile, when he removed this particular top or the tip of the coleoptile, which is the groin region of the old coleoptile, so what happened, there was no bending response. So again, he did not stop here. Light proof cap on tip, so what he did, he did not remove the tip or and he placed a light proof cap here on the tip of the old coleoptile. So what happened, again there was no bending response. So it was clear from these experiments that the response is initiated in the tip. Groin region or the tip region of the old coleoptile is responsible for the response of phototropism. So after that, Boyce and Jensen in 1915 carried out experiment on the old coleoptile as well. So what he does, he removed the tip and inserted gelatin. So what is gelatin? Gelatin is a jelly-like material. So what happened, there was a placed gelatin. So gelatin से जो भी tip में जो भी compound या chemical जो produce हो रहे थे, gelatin जो है उनको pass होने में जो है transport होने में उनको help करता है या उनको transport होने देता है. तो इसमें ये जो barrier है gelatin का, it means it is not stopping that particular signal which is coming from the tip. तो अगर tip remove कर दी जाए तो उसमें फिर कोई भी response नहीं आता. लेकिन अगर उस tip को remove करके और उसके मिडल में और बाकी टिप और बाकी प्लांट के मिडल में एक जेलेटिन का उसने एक प्लेट इंसर्ट कर दी. सो व्हाट हैपेंस, बेंडिंग रिस्पांस वाज आल्सो सीन, कि देयर वाज अ बेंडिंग रिस्पांस टुवर्ड्स द सोर्स ऑफ लाइट. इट मींस द थिंग व्हिच इज प्रोड्यूस्ड हियर इन द टिप, इट इज ट्रांसपोर्टेड टू द लोअर पार्ट ऑफ द प्लांट. सो पॉल इन 1919 आल्सो कैरिड आउट एक्सपेरिमेंट. सो व्हाट ही डज, ही रिमूव द टिप ऑफ द ओट कोलियोप्टाइल and he placed tip on the one side of the plant and not on the other. So what happened, bending in absence of light. So if there was absence of light, light was not present, but this particular bending had occurred. And what he concluded, that there is a something chemical, something or the chemical or the signaling molecule which is made here in the tip of the plant, and now when we place this particular tip at the plant on one side, so this particular chemical will be transported to the lower part of the plant and this particular bending response can be seen. So as the last Wendt, F.W. Wendt in 1928 also carried out his experiment. Aur us experiment kya tha? So what he does, he removed the tips of the plant aur un tips jo thi wo coleoptile ki, iska matlab kya hai ki usme wo jo chemical hai या जो हार्मोन है या जो सिग्नलिंग एजेंट है वो उन टिप्स में पहले से ही मौजूद था. सो व्हाट ही डज, ही प्लेस्ड दोस कोलियोप्टाइल टिप्स ऑन एगर प्लेट. एगर, सिंपल एगर, एगर जिसको हम कहते हैं, जिसको हम लेबोरेटरी में यूज करते हैं एज ए जेलीफाइंग एजेंट. तो उसने उन ओट कोलियोप्टाइल की टिप्स को प्लेस कर दिया एगर के, एगर पे. तो इसका मतलब है 2 घंटे 3 घंटे 4 घंटे वो टिप्स जो है वो एगर के ऊपर उसने उसको रखे रखा. उससे क्या हुआ कि जो केमिकल था वो ट्रांसपोर्ट हो गया, वो डिफ्यूज हो गया इस एगर के प्लेट्स में. सो व्हाट ही डिड, ही कटेड दैट पर्टिकुलर एगर इनटू अ ब्लॉक्स एंड इंस्टेड ऑफ प्लेसिंग दैट पर्टिकुलर शूट टिप्स आर कोलियोप्टाइल टिप्स, ही प्लेस्ड दीज एगर ब्लॉक्स ऑन द स्टेम. सो व्हाट ही नोटिस्ड, दैट देयर वाज अ बेंडिंग रिस्पांस टुवर्ड्स द लाइट आर बेंडिंग रिस्पांस आर डिफरेंशियल ग्रोथ. तो जिस तरफ एगर ब्लॉक को रखा गया उस तरफ ग्रोथ ज्यादा थी और जिस तरफ एगर ब्लॉक नहीं था उस तरफ ग्रोथ कम थी, इसीलिए ये बेंडिंग रिस्पांस जो है वो यहाँ पे आया. सो दिस पर्टिकुलर बेंडिंग रिस्पांस इज बिकॉज ऑफ द स्लोअर ग्रोथ. तो जिस साइड पे वो केमिकल डिफ्यूज हुआ उस साइड पे ग्रोथ ज्यादा हुआ, जिस तरफ वो केमिकल जो है वो डिफ्यूज नहीं हुआ, सो देयर वाज ए स्लोअर ग्रोथ. सो आफ्टर दीज ऑल एक्सपेरिमेंट इट वाज कंक्लूडेड दैट देयर इज समथिंग, there is a chemical which is synthesized in the tips of the coleoptile and then it is transported towards the lower part of the plant and their phototropic response is initiated. And after these all experiments and many other, it was concluded that that particular chemical is auxin. So in other way, these all experiments are also attributed to the discovery of auxin as well. So when we discuss about the auxin, so this is also the discovery of auxin and we also discuss it in the mechanism of phototropism. So this is a simple experiment of F.W. Wendt. So what he did, he auxin in tip of seedling. So when it was growing in the normal condition towards the light, So due to light condition, phototropism, auxin was synthesized here at the tip of the oat coleoptile. So what he did, he removed this particular tip and placed that particular coleoptile tip on the agar block. Now that auxin which was synthesized here in the root tip is transported in the auxin and it is diffused into agar blocks. So instead of placing that particular root or coleoptile tip, he placed this particular agar block tip on the one side. So auxin which was present in the agar block, now it is at the one side, and now auxin from the agar block will diffuse into the oat coleoptile, and now the bending response will be present. So this was the simple experiment carried out by F.W. Wendt, and it explains the mechanism of phototropism.